Hello and welcome back to Hot Mess Science. I have a question today. Shall we tell my fortune? Have you ever used one of these fortune teller miracle fishes? They're pretty great. So you can get them packs of 100 from a lot of party supply stores. And so you have a little package here with a fish inside, and on the back it tells you what your mood is. It predicts your mood or personality based on what the fish does. Okay, so let's see if this fish can predict my mood. So it tells you to lay it flat in your hand and observe what the fish does. And so the options are, does it move its head? Does it move its tail? Wow, the whole thing just sort of jumped in my hand. Does it curl in on the sides? Does it turn over? So what is it that this is doing? I think I see the sides curling in. Let me see if I can get a better view of that. Yeah, the sides turning in. Not so much the tail or the head, just the sides. I'm gonna give that another minute here. What's happening? Is this little piece of what feels like plastic, right? It is part of polymer, but is this telling my future? Is this sensing my inner personality right now? And no, that's not what's happening. So I'm gonna give my final thing here is, I think my final reading is the curling side. That's a popular one, actually, in my years of doing this with students. So curling sides means that I am fickle. And so the word fickle, while we probably don't use it a lot, but it means that you change your mind a lot, right? Maybe you change your mind about what your interests are, or where your loyalties lie. You can be fickle in love, meaning that you maybe change the object of your affection often. So apparently I am quite fickle. The fish has now flattened out. I had left it on my table and it is now totally flat, and I can go ahead and try it again and see if I'm in the same mood. But what's really happening here with this fish? Well, I'll tell you. What's really happening is that there's a salt compound in here called sodium polyacrylate. It's actually one of the same salts that are in diapers. And it grabs on to moisture. It doesn't absorb it. It just sort of grabs it. And when it grabs on to moisture, it changes the shape of the polyacrylate molecule shape slightly. So it just changes the molecule shape temporarily while it's grabbing onto that water. So where's the water coming from? Well, there's moisture in our palms, right? There's moisture coming off of our bodies. That's just part of what happens when an organic being respires, right? There's water given off as one of the waste products. So the part of the fish that is in contact with my skin is grabbing onto that water, and the shape of that molecule is now changed a little bit. The parts of the fish that are not touching my skin, they aren't grabbing on to any water, and so they're unchanged. So that's how we get a change in shape here, that depends on what parts of the fish are making contact in my hand. So what might be interesting to think about is, what kind of testing can you do on this? What could you do next to test the sodium polyacrylate and how it grabs onto water? Would you want to try different people's hands? Maybe you could put it on your foot, or your leg, or the top of your head. Maybe you want to put it on things that aren't even alive. Maybe you want to test dipping the whole fish in water and then putting it on your hand and seeing what kind of reaction you get. So you just let it sit aside for 5 minutes, and then you can try it again and have fun investigating what your mood is. But also what happens to sodium polyacrylate when it grabs onto water. See see you soon.